Yes, this is the last point we have seen in previous class. SQL Server is a collection of what? Four servers. Okay, so one is what? Database engine is it, which we are working as a DBA regularly. So then here analysis services, integration services, and reporting services. But we know that our job is what? To work with what? Database engine only. Our database server only is here. Our responsibilities are what? To work with what? Database server only. Okay, right. Right. So this was like, that's why whenever we are installing SQL Server, last class I have shown you, they will send us complete information. Okay, so complete information they will send actually. So which server should be installed, right? So check here, like here, generally say like database engine is one. So whenever we run the query, whenever the user runs the query, so that query is processed by which server? Database engine or database server? Database server. Right. So say like, these are three other servers we have. So these servers are called MSBI features, Microsoft Business Intelligence features. MSBI features. Right. Check your SQL Server components are there. Already we have discussed. SQL Server Management Studio is there, through which we are connecting and working with SQL Server. See, in the SSMS here, whenever we type the command, once we click on execute button, just remember request is submitted to which server, which service, SQL Server service in the background. This SQL Server service will process the command. We are getting the result back. We are getting the result back here. That's why remember queries are processed by which server? SQL Server service. The background remember queries are processed by which service? SQL Server service, which is our main service. Database engine service. Right. Right. So that's like that's why we have seen while to start working with SQL Server, we have to go with what? It is a two-step process here. To start installation, SQL Server installation, we are going with what? Two-step process. Okay, right, right. So that is like, check here. We have seen first we have to install this SQL Server service or database engine. Then we have to install this SSMS. I will show once again, installation process, we'll see once again, okay? Yes, next here like, SQL Server in a machine. How SQL Server is there in a machine? We can see here. Check it, this is my server one. Server one or one system actually and our laptop. See here, just one point we have to understand. Whenever we are installing SQL Server, we are creating one instance. See here, instance. Whenever we install SQL Server, remember, we are creating actually one instance. One instance here. Okay, so that is like, then see like, just so that's why we have to understand here, like SQL, one instance is nothing but what? One copy of SQL Server. Why? Because remember, for some clients, remember, we have to maintain multiple instances. For example, banking clients are there. We have to maintain here multiple instances. One instance for one instance for like one instance for loans department, one instance for net banking, one instance for cards, one instance for RBI transactions. Like this here, multiple instances generally here we are maintaining. Basic idea is here to divide the similar databases, we have to go with what? Multiple instances. Basic idea is what? To divide the similar databases, we are going with multiple instances. Right? Yes. So that's what remember like a instance is basically what? One copy of SQL Server. Check here again. Generally in SQL Server, we have two types of instances are there. One is here like default instance is there. Second one is named instances. That's it. Two types of instances. Default and named instances. Okay. Default instance is there whose name is equal to my system name. See it? Whose name is equal to what? System name. That is called default instance. Whereas named instance is there, system name slash some name is there, sir. That is the named instance here. System name slash some name, which is here named instance. Right. So in general, remember, in one machine, we can have one default instance here, 49 named instances. One default instance, 49 named instances here, total 50 instances. Means what it's meaning? We can install SQL Server 50 times maximum. We can install SQL Server 50 times here maximum, 50 times. Okay, one is default instance. Of remaining 49 are named instances here. Okay, just remember there is no much difference actually between default or named instances. So just remember like generally these default instances are used for monitoring purpose in general for monitoring purpose here. Right. Check here again. Yeah, under each instance here, like hierarchy, we have to understand. In one machine, we can have one or more instances. Under each instance, we have one or more databases here. Databases. Under database, we have a schema. Under that, we have objects. Objects are basically what? Tables or views or stored procedures like this here. Those are the objects. That is the hierarchy we have to understand here. Okay, one machine is there. In that machine, we have instances are the maximum we have seen. Under instance, we have databases. And check here, in every instance, maximum we can have these many databases here. 32,767 databases we have to understand. Maximum. And in every database here, we have schemas are there. Just remember, schema is like a folder to group the tables. We have schemas here. Under that, we have objects. Objects are nothing but what? Tables, views, stored procedures, everything here. Same thing, maximum 32,767 objects here, maximum. Maximum 32,767 objects per database, means including tables, views, everything. Just remember, schemas are there for what purpose? For grouping purpose. Why? Because one database is their college database. In that database, we have 5,000 tables. For example, Then remember which table is for what purpose, right? Yeah, confusion is there, right? Yes, that's why remember to avoid that confusion, we have to understand here. We can use the schemas like library dot students, okay? Hostel dot students. Like this here, we can divide the databases here like into what schemas here. Schemas. Schema is basically for what? Grouping purpose here. Grouping purpose. Okay, right. So that is like schemas are there here. Okay, right. So check here like yes, schemas are there. Understood, right? Hierarchy, all the people. In one machine, we can have what? One or more instances. Under each instance, we have DBs. Under that schema, under that objects here. Understood, right? This is the instance hierarchy is there. Instance hierarchy is there. How the databases are there in a machine. In general, remember, like we can have. See, in real time, remember, we have only one instance per machine. In real time, we have only one instance per machine here. We don't have so many instances. But in developer machine or development server, we can have multiple instances like this. We can have multiple instances like this in case of a development servers, developers machine. Okay, right. Check here like instances. Instance here, separate copy of same software product is called what? Instance here. Separate copy of same software product is called instance. We can have maximum 50 instances per machine. Per machine, already we have discussed, no? One default instance, 49 named instances here. Okay, so that is like right. So check here. Default instance is there and named instance is there. Two types of instances are there here. Okay, two types of instances we have discussed already. So every instance has here its own binaries and its own folders. Check your default instance is there. Named instances are there. So default instance is there here whose name is, its service name is always here. MS SQL Server. Means what? If you see here service name SQL Server in bracket MS SQL Server, it is a default instance. Okay, but if you see like SQL Server in bracket some name, then remember it is a named instance. Okay, see here we have seen already like if I go to SQL. Sorry, services dot msc. See here, services dot msc. Okay. Here, see, click somewhere. Press yes. Okay, you can see here SQL Server. See here, so many instances are there in my machines here. Means what? These many times I have installed SQL Server in my machines here. Many instances of it, SQL Server with different names. But this is here, if you see SQL Server in bracket MS SQL Server, then it is a default instance or named instance. Arun? Lalito? Manoj? Which type of instance it is? If you see, SQL Server in bracket MS SQL Server. Yes. Yeah. Correct. Understood, right? Other people. Muhammad. Yes. Yeah, default it stands. But whenever we see, remember, other than MS SQL Server, any names like this here. Okay. Loans, Metro HYD, Metro SQL, Mumbai SP, any names here. Other than MS SQL Server, maybe MS SQL Server 01, 02, 03, anything other than MS SQL Server, then remember it is a named instance. Is a named instance other than MS SQL Server. Right. So check here. Next one. While connecting, we have seen we can use one tool called SSMS, SQL Server Management Studio. See here, Microsoft SQL Server Management Studio, SSMS. Okay. Right. In this machine, how many instances are there? We can check here. Server name, browse for more. See here. Database engine. Okay. Right. Here, see, like first instance name is a default instance. First instance name is what? Default instance, right? Just we have seen. SQL Server is there. Right? SQL Servers here. System name, sorry. System name is there, right? That's why it is a default instance. Only system name is there. That's why it is a default instance here. Understood, right? Yes. So default instance here, all these are system name slash some name is it. All these are here like named instances. Named instances here. Okay. So like understood it. If you see system name, or if the service is MS SQL Server, okay, if the service is what? MS SQL Server, then remember it is a default instance. Whenever we see system name slash some name, then remember it is a named instance here. So many times I have installed. Actually, you have to uninstall, otherwise performance problems will get. Why? Because every instance needs some RAM, some CPU, right? That's why performance problems will get. Right. Yes, that's like every instance has its own services. Yeah, its own folders. Take care, like instance summary, we'll see before going with custom installation. See, these are the main four major components are there. Every instance has four major components. As a DBA, we have to understand very clearly. As a DBA, we have to understand here very clearly. What is here? Every instance has its own services here. Right, already we know these two are our main services. SQL Server and SQL Server Agent are our main services here. Understood, right? Yes, SQL Server and SQL Server Agent are our main services. Right, so check it. Second one, see, like. Every instance has its own folders here. In general, remember, whenever we install SQL Server, automatically in the background, some folders are created. Arun is asking, in case of cluster, right? You are asking, Arun. Yes. Yeah, generally we have 16 instances in general, but depends on which version. So from 2014 onwards, we can have 25 instances also. Depends on which version, Arun. Okay, we'll see again in clustering concept. Right. Take care, understood, right? Every instance has its own folders here. Right now I have connected to, let's say we'll connect to one of the instance. Yeah, check here, Mumbai SBI, for example, connect. So I want to see in which drive I have installed this instance. For example, in which drive I have installed this SQL Server software, I want to see. Check here, we can see right click, properties, root directory. Okay, yes, we can see here, see in which drive we have installed SQL Server. Go to run, paste this, go to this path. Here, see, yeah, we have its own folders are things here. Yeah, this is our main folder, MS SQL 15 dot instance name. Okay, MS SQL 15 dot instance name. This is the main folder. Okay, so under that here, MS SQL, under that some subfolders are things here. Just remember, that's why by default, every instance has its own folders. Okay, we'll talk about this one by one in detail. After installation, I will discuss these folders again one by one. What is there in which folder? Just one point, remember, this bin and install are called software folders. But SQL Server is working by using these two folders, mainly bin folders here. Bin folder is nothing but what? Binaries folder. Instance binaries are there here in bin folders here. Bin folder, binaries folder it is. Okay, right. So some other folders are there. Just one point I will discuss here later after installation also. We have this concept is it in module 2. There I will discuss in detail. Backup is a default folder for backups. Means what? Whenever we create a database backup, it is created into this folder automatically. Data folder is the database files are there here. Means every database has data file, log file. Those files are created here by default in the data folder. FT data is the full text data. We'll see later. Jobs folder is the, basically we have seen here, jobs are there to perform any scheduled activities. To schedule anything, remember, we have jobs are there. To schedule anything, we have jobs are there here. Okay, so this one, but like, jobs are there. We'll see as part of automation, remember, we'll create the jobs actually. Right. Next year, like log folder is there, another very, very important folder. Here we have error logs are there, here, error logs. Very, very important point we have to understand. As a DB, remember, regularly we have to work with what? Error logs. Anything happen in SQL Server? Anything happen in SQL Server, remember? If any errors are there in SQL Server, those errors are captured into this error log. Errors are captured into what? Error logs here, by default. By default. So that's why if anything happened tomorrow, like log shipping fail, mirroring fail, replication fail, anything happen, remember tomorrow. First step is what? First step is what? Checking the error log. Understood, right? First steps here, we can open the error log. We can see what happened exactly. Thus, remember, error logs are very, very important for us. Okay, anything happen in SQL Server, first step is what? We have to check the error logs here. Already we know our regular job is what? Troubleshooting, right? Yes, as part of troubleshooting, remember, we have to check the logs regularly. As part of troubleshooting, we have to check the error logs regularly. Okay, right. So that is like we can open this error log with Notepad. We can see here. Okay, information, step-by-step details plus errors, both are recorded here. Information plus errors, both are recorded here in the error log. Yeah, Manoj is asking. Backup folder. Backup folder is what? Whenever we take backup of database without mentioning the complete path, like D drive or E drive or F, right? By default, that backup file is created into this backup folder. For example, here, directly I'm saying some file name, master.bak. This file is created in what? Backup. Why? Because I have not mentioned anywhere here D drive or E drive or F drive, right? So by default here, this master.bak is created here. See, just not yet, but yet. Okay, right. That's why default location for backups is what? Backup. We'll see again one more time. Yeah, log folder, understood, right? Error logs are there here in log folder, which we have to monitor regularly. REPL data folder is a replication data folder is a replication data folder maintain. This is used for replication purpose. Means what? Whenever we configure one feature called replication in SQL Server, then this folder is used. Then this folder is used here. These are like different folders are there here as part of every instance. Okay, every instance has its own folders, its own services, its own error logs, plus its own system databases here. Yeah, master MSDB model TemDB resource. By default, remember, whenever we install SQL Server, automatically these five system databases are created automatically. In these system databases, remember, instance metadata is there. Means what? Tomorrow I want to see on which databases I have scheduled backups. We can see here, see the MSDB database. Okay. The same way, I want to see in this server how many databases are there that we can see in master database. Understood, right? Metadata as a DBA, if we want to see to which user what permissions we have granted, to which in which database how many files are there. Okay, so jobs information, automation information. Everything is recorded in which databases? System databases here. Actually, our applications like Paytm, PhonePe, or GPay, or anything here, applications are connected with which database? Applications are connected to their own databases, right? Yeah, applications are connected to their own database here. Okay, so but remember this system databases maintains what? Instance metadata. That's why we have to work with these system databases. As a DBA, we have to work with what? System databases. Understood, right? Yes. So that's why we have to understand here. System databases are very, very important for us as a DPA. We have to work with what? System databases regularly. Okay, right. So that's like different types of databases are there. We have to understand. Understood, right? System databases. Yes, we'll see one by one in detail again. Okay, so just one point remember, master maintains all the server level settings. Master database maintains what? All the server level settings here. Okay, second one's here like this. MSDB maintains automation information, Microsoft scheduling database. Means what? Jobs automation information is there in which database? MSDB database here. Automation information is there in MSDB database. Okay. Just remember, like automation information is there in MSDB database here. Means like jobs, alerts, maintenance plans, all the scheduled activities are maintained here in MSDB database. All the scheduled activities are maintained in MSDB database. You have to understand. Understood it? Yes. So that's remember all the scheduled activities are there in MSDB database. Then next one's here, model database is there. Model database is a template for new databases. Means what? Whenever I create a new database, okay, this database should be created with how much size? Okay, it depends on model database. As a DBA, we are not we are not working regularly here as a DBA. Okay, as a DBA, we are not working regularly. We have to understand. Right. So that is like we have to understand here. See, like we have MSDB model database. TempDB database is there which maintains all the temporary objects. TempDB is like our system's RAM, right? Whenever you open some database, whenever we open some in TempDB here, like whenever we perform some sorting, grouping, joining, re-indexing, all those are maintained here. All those are done in TempDB database. We'll see again. Resource database is there, which is a hidden database, which is used for patching purpose. Patching purpose. Right. This is see, every instance has here these four main databases, main objects are there, sir, in every instance. Every instance has its own services, its own folders, its own system databases, its own error logs. Okay, right. So we'll talk about this again, folders in detail and system databases, error logs also in detail in our next classes. Right. So this is like, yeah, just what is what we have seen again. So what I will do, I'll conclude the session here. In today's class, we have to understand instances. We have to understand two types of instances we have seen, default and named instances we have seen. This is your instance summary also we have to understand. As a DBA, yeah, these four Yeah, four major components we have to understand here in STAND summary. Four major components are there with every instance. That is like we have to check here, see, like what is, these two are the main concepts we have seen. I will show you again custom installation, means how we are doing installation in production server in tomorrow's class. We'll see. It may take some time. That's why we'll conclude the session now. We'll see the custom installation. That.